we're getting things done because BB is such a great word. Gets us up. We're moving stuff this morning and everything. He's doing that. What? My vote would be I would vote Ramona off. Because BB is such a great word. Gets us up. We're moving stuff this morning and everything. I mean, we're getting things done because BB's there too. He's doing that. As soon as we had breakfast, Ramona was back in bed. We want food. Gretchen, Colleen, and Greg, they were out looking for tapioca so that we could have mashed potato-style tapioca root. But it's also just to get away from the daily grind here. I mean, we're gonna be here 39 days. You gotta keep yourself happy.
Oh, I'm so ready to eat rat. I wanna gut him, bone him, and then we're gonna have like some little rat meat in with the rice that we're eating. That would be delicious.
We're feeling a little bit defensive, but we're also feeling like we can do it. We can beat them, because we got a really light person and a really strong team pulling it.
I don't think Ramona's pulling her weight. Oh, I think that she really thought she could handle us, and now she's finding that I don't think she can as much as she thought.
I think Ramona has changed her attitude. Well, no, changed her work ethic a lot. But I don't think her attitude has changed much. She is working more. She's trying. But I think maybe it is a little too late.
I don't want to make that check tonight. We got to win.
Going to this island council meeting tonight, it's really tough. The thought of eliminating any of these people that we're placing all of our confidence in, it's getting worse. I can't imagine and I can't fathom voting off somebody from this team tonight. Speed-wise, we got right down there. We got right down to the treasure chest and just kept collapsing in, and it was so devastating. All day I had this feeling that my leg would be the one that would lose it for us, and it did. It does make me feel vulnerable for the vote tonight.
For some reason, the last 2 or 3 days, we've just been really down. I think it's got a lot to do with just we lost 2 in a row, we lost a member of the group, and one of who I consider one of our male leaders, Greg, was really feeling terrible. He's got an ear infection. He's really sick. I don't know what brought us down, but it seems like winning that challenge just brought everybody right back up. I can't speak for the rest of the tribe, but I really wanted to win because it was food. I wanted to win that more than any of the other rewards thus far. Unexpectedly, we came back with 3 live chickens, which was absolutely wonderful. Well, we're gonna see if they produce any eggs, but I'm really thinking that we're gonna wait every other day and eat a chicken.
I noticed they seem to be spending their nights out under the stars and cuddling up. I think it's stepped up a notch, maybe. A little romance going on.
You can look at it as a disadvantage that Jervis can't swim, but we all are gonna have our differences. Not all of us are gonna be strong at everything.
Oh, we're gonna eat 3 chickens in 3 days because we want to eat them before we merge tribes. We don't want them getting any of our chickens. Besides, one of them was pecking the hell out of me.
I've never gone through the process of feeding a chicken, watering a chicken, then butchering a chicken.
Yum. Ooh, yeah.
I can smell the, like, the grease meat. And it's gonna fry and it's gonna bubble and... Oh.
I didn't see him do anything yesterday. But that is nothing new, and that surprises me that I still haven't voted for Jervis. He doesn't seem to pull his own weight, and I know for a fact that he voted against me. So why the hell have I voted for him? I don't know.
Joel thinks he's the All-American, and all of these physical challenges are just feeding his ego.
Towards the ladies, he seems to be pretty condescending. Like, he has to explain everything so thoroughly that we just couldn't understand it without Joel.
Throw it over there and then kind of tie it to one of these things.
Yeah.
And bring it from here.
Let's just try it like this first. I know that gamey taste is going to be pretty harsh.
I don't see why he feels the need to treat us like we're children.
I know who my vote is, and it would be Joel. But I can't speak for the rest of the tribe. I got a vote last time, so maybe I'll be off.
I immediately saw the table set up with... it was like a romantic dinner. It was like this table all set up with everything. 2 beds off to the right. Single, like, really nice with sheets and pillows and blankets and... like a stump, we had a bedside table, we had lanterns everywhere, tiki torches, and the first thing I thought was, oh man, they're so setting this up for it to be romantic with Sean. And there's not a spark there. We saw Pagong's fire was still lit, so I was like, oh, I want to call home. They're probably worried. And so we threw a bunch of kerosene on our fire to make it whoosh, and they said they saw that, so I hoped that they would figure that I was still there, that I was okay. We talked all night. It helped that they had 4 bottles of wine there. So we drank them all. And we were both pretty drunk. Actually, Actually, Sean let me do almost all the deciding. I came up with the name, he added an A on the end. I did feel sadness when we left Pagong. Like, looking back, that was where we rode to the first day when we were shipwrecked. It was where I'd formed a bond with seven other people, so it was sad, but it was like a new beginning forming a whole nother tribe. They welcomed us with open arms. We got along really well. I think Rudy's very set in his ways, so having, you know, five new people move in, it scared him a lot. So he was just sitting back and he was assessing the situation, I think. First night as one tribe, we sat around the campfire, told stories, very, very, very revealing stories. Oh yeah, people were getting kicked in the head all night long because he got out like three times and he would just barrel through people. Coming into this merger, I consider it a brand new tribe. I want to vote based on people's merits. I don't want to vote based on let's get rid of each of them first and then come back to our tribe. I want to vote based on who I really think should go, whether it be a member of our tribe or a member of theirs. Last night, it looks like there was a conspiracy. And maybe I'm being paranoid and I didn't want to believe it, but four people from Tagi voted for Gretchen, I think. As far as Pagong, we are now four. They are now five. They do have a voting block on us, whether we see it or not, and they can pick us off one by one.
Cool, man.
My best strategy is to bond with the women and try to hold on to the women's vote as long as I can. I do see the woman versus man vote continuing on in Ratana. As far as my three votes, top, they're all men.
Oh, God, you guys.
I see the women go out, get the crab traps, the woman fix the hut. We're carrying the weight of the team. Maybe that's unfair, but that's how I see it. I'm seeing Greg in a much more devious way than I've ever seen him before. Since we moved, I saw him change so much and so transparently to me anyway that I've changed my whole attitude towards Greg. Greg is working just about everybody in the group. I think he's always had Colleen like wrapped around his little finger. Rich finds Greg attractive. So Rich throws these little innuendos out there, and Greg will just pick right up on him, sit right real close to Rich, and he's playing. I can't imagine anybody missing their kids more than I do every night. Miss my beauties. Miss Sadie and Sabrina. I can't imagine my mom not getting the tape out. I would have done wonders to see that my kids were okay. Hear their voices. Hear, I love you, Mommy. That's my bruises. From the bow and arrow. This is from the bow and arrow. Jervis, I don't see him doing very much.
I knew coming here that we'd have to vote people off. What I didn't bank on was the feelings that you'd have towards these people.
I think, it disappointed Rich that us girls kept these crab traps going and that we caught a fish. I want the letter from Homer. Because I can go back and get right. But I haven't seen or heard anything from my kids.
And I'm sure he does love to be naked, and I'm glad for that. And I thought I would be okay with that. But sitting at the fire this morning, and he comes just walking up and sits like 2 inches from me, naked. I wanted to get away.
All the nakedness. I've been having a problem with this. Huh?
It felt awkward sitting next to a naked gay man. And if he had like something to cover the butt crack area, I'd be cool with that.
Yesterday at the dinner, we had a whole conversation about forming a new alliance.
Yeah.
We're gonna vote the same, and we figured that this puts us in jeopardy for the next one. But we were in jeopardy anyway. So the rest of my alliance, if that's what you want to call it, yeah, we're all voting for Rich. He's ruthless. And the fact that we're voting him out on his birthday, it's not lost on me. We're giving him a birthday present.
Well, I had a good time. It was a great time on the island. I felt like I was targeted tonight because they knew that Sean would vote for me alphabetically, so they knew they'd get an easy off with me. They were more powerful because Pagong went into it a little naive. So that's it. I had a really good time. And no hard feelings, and nothing's taken personally.